Hey there, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over an example on special triangles. We're going to be dealing with a composite case where we have a triangle that is a combination of the two special triangles, the 30, 60, 90, and the 45, 45, 90 special triangles, okay? And that's illustrated in this figure here below. So the instructions are for us to find the values of x and y, right? So in order for us to do this problem, what we have to do is basically split this triangle into two separate triangles and then treat them independently, okay? Now, in order for us to be able to find the value of y, we need to find the length of this segment. Since we already have x taken, how about we call the segment A? And then we have to find the length of this segment. And how about we call this B? And then we can call this segment right here C. All right? So in order to find y, we need to find A and B combined, all right? And then we'll have another triangle here. So let's go ahead and draw these two triangles separately. I'm just going to make a rough sketch on the right side. So let's say we have this is the 30, 60, 90 triangle. Let's put it right over here. All right, let's focus on this one first. We need to find this portion. How long is this segment, this portion of y right here, so that we can then shift our attention to B and then go from there, right? So how long is that portion? So this is 18. We know that the hypotenuse is 18. This is a 90 degree angle. This is 30. If this is 30, then this angle here must be 60 degrees. So this is a 30, 60, 90 triangle. This side is A. And this side here is C. It will be beneficial for us to find the measure of C because in this other triangle we know the measure of no sides at all, and we need at least one side in order to be able to find the other sides using the special triangle. All right, so let's find A and C in this triangle right here. Now, before we do that, let's draw the base 30, 60, 90 triangle. I'm going to draw it on the side right here. Let's use a green marker. So this is the base 30, 60, 90 triangle. It's going to guide how I'm going to populate the denominators of this side in a minute. So the base 30, 60, 90 triangle is as follows. Opposite, the bigger of the two angles that are not right is 60 degrees, and then opposite that side is root 3. And then opposite the smallest angle, 30 degrees, is 1. And then opposite the hypotenuse is 2. All right, this is the base 30, 60, 90 triangle. Okay, this is the model that we use to create the other one. So this is a similar to this, is scaled up by a certain factor. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to set it up as follows. Underneath the 90 degree angle, I mean the side opposite the 90 degree angle, I'm going to put a 2 because you notice that there's a 2 opposite the 90 degree angle on the base triangle. Opposite the side opposite of 60 degrees, I'm going to put it over root 3. And then opposite the 30 degrees, I'm going to put it over 1. All right, so let's find A and B. So let's start off by finding, let's find A. Okay, so to find A, we're going to set the ratio that we are missing a side that we have a variable in with the ratio that has no variable at all, which is this ratio right here. Okay? So let's go ahead and set up the ratio and then solve. So we're going to have, let's see, a over root 3 is equal to 18 over 2. All right. So to get a isolated, we'll multiply both sides by root 3 on the left and root 3 on the right. And while doing that, we can also see here that these two divide out. Okay. So this root 3 and root 3 divide out 1 and 1. And then we're left with a on the left side equals, now on the right side, 2 goes here 1, and then 2 goes here 9 times. So we have a side measure of a being equal to 9 root 3. Okay? All right, now let's go ahead and find c. Let's find c. All right, to find c, we're going to set up the ratio that involves c, c over 1. Equals the ratio that we know the values of both sides, 18 over 2, 18 over 2. All right, let's go ahead and solve for C. C over 1 is just C. 18 over 2 is 9. Okay, so we have C and A. All right, so let me box them, and then I'm going to be putting them in back into the triangle in a minute so we can know what where we're at. So that's A, and then that's C. So let's roll up. This portion right here, C is 9. So this portion here is 9. And then A is 9 root 3. So this portion right here is 9 root 3. Okay? All right, now let's shift our attention to the second triangle. This is a 45, 45, 90 triangle. Let's go ahead and sketch it over here. We're treating them independently. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so there goes your third. Let's draw that again. So we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me put it right here so you can see that they're actually separated from one another. Like that. Like that. All right, so there goes the 45, 45, 90 triangle, this portion of this whole composite triangle. All right, so we have 45 here. And then this side is X, and then we agreed to call this side B, right? What is the measure of this side? It's C, but we already know what C is. What is the value of C? C from the other triangle we're able to determine is equal to 9, okay? All right, now to solve this triangle for X and B, we're going to create our base triangle, the base model for the 45 and 45, 90 triangle. Let's put it on the side right here. And then it will guide how we can populate the denominators, all right? So I'm just gonna draw a little base, 45, 45, 90 triangle right here. Okay, and then we have, this is 45, this is 45 right here, and that's 45. Opposite the 45s, we have 1, so this is a 1, and this is a 1, and opposite the 90 degrees, we have root 2. All right, so there goes your base 45, 45, 90 triangle. All right, so what does that tell me here? The side opposite 45 is a 1, so 9 is going to be over 1, B is going to be over 1, and then the side opposite 90 degrees is root 2. Okay, so put this over root 2. All right. So this is what we get because the two triangles are similar. So let's start off by finding B. So let's find B. Find side B. To do that, we're going to set up the ratio that has a variable with the ratio that doesn't have any variables at all, which is 9 over 1. Set both of them equal to that, all right? So to find B, we're going to set the ratio of B over 1, all right? And then equals 9 over 1. B over 1 is just B, 9 over 1 is just 9, so there you have it. Alright, so now let's find X. To find X, what we're going to do is set up a ratio X over root 2 is equal to 9 over 1. To get X isolated, we'll multiply both sides by root 2, root 2, root 2, and then this root 2's cancel out. Final answer, X is going to be equal to 9 root 2. So those are the measures of the sides of the 45, 45, 90 triangle, okay? So let's put that back in there. B turns out to be the same as C. B is 9. Let's put that there. So this portion right here is 9. And then X is 9 root 2. Is that what we got? Yes. X is 9 root 2, all right, so the question asks us to find X and Y. So we can see from this shape that X is equal to 9 root 2, and then Y is actually a sum of this base of this 30, 60, 90 triangle and the base of this 45, 45, 90 triangle. So it's going to be the sum of these two combined. So that answer is going to be 9 plus 9 root 3. All right, so that's the measure of the sides of this composite triangle that we have right here. All right, so let's go ahead and box our answer. Now, thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to my channel and post a comment to let me know what you think about this clip. And if you liked it, do give me a thumbs up. Appreciate it. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.